Forget about a fourth musketeer and don't worry about a fifth beetle, because there is a sixth platonic solid and it's hiding where you least expect it. We call 2D shapes like this equilateral triangle polygons. But this triangle is a special shape. It's what's known as a regular polygon. And that just means that all of its edges and all of its vertices are absolutely identical. But actually, it's not that special. There are loads of these. After the regular triangle comes the regular rectangle, or square, as you may know it, then the regular pentagon, and so on. There are hexagons and heptagons, there are octagons and nonagons. It carries on for ages, gradually just looking more and more like a circle. And that's the problem in 2D. There aren't enough limitations. There are technically infinitely many possible regular 2D polygons. In 3D, however, things get a lot more interesting. We can join 2D polygons together to make 3D polyhedrons at polyhedra, whatever. More importantly, here I have one of them. This is a tetrahedron, and it is a regular polyhedron, which means not only are its faces made up of regular polygons, in this case you can see they're all equilateral triangles, but on top of that, where those regular 2D faces meet, form identical vertices in 3D. And regular polyhedrons are far more exciting than regular polygons, and that's because they're a lot rarer. There are only 5 possible versions of this shape. We call them the Platonic solids because Plato absolutely loved them, and here they all are. Number 1, the tetrahedron, made of 4 identical equilateral triangles that all meet 3 to a vertex. Number 2, the cube, made of 6 identical squares, which, like the tetrahedron, all meet 3 to a vertex. Number 3, the octahedron, also made of identical equilateral triangles, but this time joined 4 to a vertex. Number 4, the dodecahedron, made of 12 identical regular pentagons, joined 3 to a vertex. Number 5, the icosahedron, 20 identical equilateral triangles, joined 5 to a vertex. And then that's it. Despite the infinitely many 2D regular shapes, there's no other way to join them together to make a regular 3D shape. We only get those 5 platonic solids. Euclid even finished his series of books, The Elements, in Book 13, Proposition 18, with the proof that there are only 5 of them. Which is not to say there aren't some other great 3D solids. This here is a rhombic dodecahedron. Very sadly, not a platonic solid though. As you can see, the faces are diamonds. Diamonds where, if they were 1 high, they're exactly root 2 across. And all the vertices aren't the same, but still, fantastic shape. And it does link to one of the platonic solids. You see, the rhombic dodecahedron is a cube turned inside out. Here I have a model of a solid cube, but made from a net of triangular pyramids. So if you put it back together this way, get the original solid cube. If you put it back together inside out though, and this helps if you put a solid cube in the middle to hold everything in place, the shape you end up with is a rhombic dodecahedron. So an inside out cube is a rhombic dodecahedron. Hang on, yes, ha ha ha, look at that, eh? It carries on into the fourth dimension, just like you can join regular 2D polygons together to make a regular 3D polyhedron, you can then join regular 3D polyhedrons together to make a regular 4D polychoron. And all 5 of them are here. If you join regular tetrahedrons together, 3 to an edge, 5 of them together in the fourth dimension will make the hypertetrahedron. 8 cubes joined 3 to an edge will make for a hypercube. 16 tetrahedrons joined 4 to an edge give the hyperoctahedron. 120 regular dodecahedrons all join 3 to an edge to make the hyperdodecahedron. And finally, if you have 600 tetrahedrons lying around, you can join them 5 to an edge to make the hypericosahedron. So there you have it. In 4D, you still have 5 platonic solids, except suddenly, there's one more. There's a 6th platonic solid in 4D, and it's the 4D equivalent of the rhombic dodecahedron. Check it out. That is 24 octahedrons all joined together, 3 to an edge. And in 4D, it is a platonic solid, often called the icosatetrahedron or the octacube. I prefer it by its name, the hyperdiamond. Even though the poor rhombic dodecahedron doesn't get to be a platonic solid in 3D, suddenly it does when you get to 4D. And there's the same cube link in 4D. If you turn a 4D cube inside out in the same rough fashion, you end up with the 4D hyperdiamond. I may have become so obsessed with the fourth dimension, I wrote a book all about it. And you can see here in chapter 10, I have all the 4D platonic solids. We have the hypertetrahedron, the hypercube, the hyperoctahedron, the hypericosahedron, and the hyperdodecahedron. And then there it is, the absolute best one. In fact, I'll highlight it right now. That is the hyperdiamond. It is the best. So there you have it, that's my video on the sixth platonic solid that only exists in the fourth dimension. If you're wondering why I haven't bothered doing a video about platonic solids in the fifth dimension, it's because there's only three of them. The 5D equivalent of the tetrahedron, the 5D equivalent of the octahedron, and the 5D equivalent of the cube. And that's it. Same in six dimensions, seven dimensions, eight dimensions, all the way up, you only ever get those three platonic solids, which is why I love the hyperdiamond. It appears briefly in the fourth dimension and then never again. To learn more about the mathematics of the fourth dimension, or indeed higher dimensions, you can buy my book, Things to Make and Do in the Fourth Dimension. What a shameless plug. Although, if you buy it on MathsGear, where I would normally sign all the books, but you mention that you watch this video, the first purchase that does that, I will give them this actual book, the one that I was drawing in the video. If you just want to learn more mathematics, then you can simply click my face to subscribe to this YouTube channel.